Hey everyone, in today's video, I'm going to show you how you can add an IR blaster to the official firmware in Flipper Zero. We'll clone the repository, and then we'll apply our edits to the different branches, release, release candidate, or dev, and then we'll install the modified firmware on the Flipper Zero. Our changes will require the IR blaster to work, but you can always go back to a previous firmware and to use the built-in IR port. The IR blaster I have is from Rabbit Labs, but any IR blaster that uses pin A7 should work. Let's get started. On the Flipper Zero firmware page, click on the green code dropdown and then click on the copy to clipboard for the HTTPS URL. In Visual Studio Code, do Ctrl+Shift+P for the command palette, type in get, and then choose get clone recursive. Paste in the URL and then click on clone from URL. And then choose a folder that you want to store your files on. I'm going to go ahead and make a new folder under my C drive. We'll call this repo. And then say select as repository destination. And then that'll take a few minutes to clone. And then once it's finished cloning, go ahead and click on open. Once it's open, say yes, I trust the authors. And next we need to populate the VS Code directory. So we will right-click on FBT and say open an integrated terminal. And then we'll type ./FBT/VSCode_dist and press enter. This will take a couple minutes as it downloads the toolchain and then populates our VS Code folder. And once it's complete, our VS Code folder should have about a half a dozen configuration files. We'll close VS Code and then we'll reopen it. And VS Code will reopen everything and process all the files. And after about 30 seconds, you should get this dialog. Go ahead and say install to install the recommended extensions. The installation will take a few minutes while it downloads and installs the extensions. And then go ahead and say allow for network access. I'm going to say no to this pre-release version question. Then in the extensions area, instead of recommended, change this to say CMake and make sure that CMake and CMake tools are not installed. If it is installed, click on it and then make sure you say disable workspace for both CMake and for CMake tools. Disable workspace. And click reload required if there's a button that says that. Once Visual Studio Code fully reloads, click on the Explorer view so you can see your files again. In QFlipper, I'm going to click on the wrench, and then I'm going to click on the firmware update channel dropdown, and you can see there's three channels, release, release candidate, and development. Release is the stable release. Release candidate is the one currently undergoing QA test, and development is the latest build. At the bottom of Visual Studio Code, you can see we're in the development branch by default, but we can choose other branches as well. So there's origin dev, but there's also origin release candidate that we could choose. And now you see the bottom has switched to release candidate. And we can click that, and we can also choose origin release. And this is the stable build. I recommend picking whichever version you normally run on your Flipper. Next, we're going to open applications, and then main, and then infrared, and then infrared app.c. I'm going to go ahead and close these pop-up windows. And then we're going to scroll down towards the bottom of the file. And this is the infrared app on our firmware. So our infrared blaster uses the 5-volt GPIO pin 1. And so we're going to write some code to enable that 5 volts. So first we're just going to check if it's already charging. And if so, we don't need to enable it. It looks like we're not getting any autocomplete. So I'm going to go ahead and do Control Shift B, and then I'll choose Build Firmware. So this process is going to take a few minutes while it builds everything. I've gone ahead and sped the video up so that we don't have to wait for the whole build. And once it's finished, close the terminal window so we can see the rest of our code. And perfect, it looks like we have autocomplete now. I've gone ahead and just pasted in the code. This code block is in the description of the video. So on line 507, we are seeing if we're charging already. And then 508, we're seeing if some other thing enabled our 5 volt pin. And then 509 is if we're not charging and we're not 5 volt enabled, then we're going to suppress charge enter, which means that if we plug the USB cable in, it's not going to do anything. We're going to set our number of attempts to 0, and then we'll try up to 5 times to enable OTG, which is the 5 volt pin when it's not connected to the USB cable. And then below that view dispatcher run, we'll add some new code that will disable the 5 volts when the application's exiting, if we were the ones that enabled it. And I put this code in the description of the video as well. And our if statement is the same as the one in 509. And we disable the 5 volts, and then we do the power suppress charge exit so that charging works again when the cable's plugged in. So I'll go ahead and close that applications folder. Next, we're going to go into targets. And then under targets, we're going to go to F7 and then FRUI_HAL and then FRUI_HAL_infrared.c. And on line 12, we're going to uncomment the //. So it just says define infrared txtdebug. Make sure you save both files. And if you look over in source control, you should see the two files with your edits. The first one should show this enable 5 volts before the view dispatcher run, and then the disable after the view dispatcher run. And then in our infrared, you should see that we no longer have the // space in front of the pound define infrared txtdebug. That looks good. So we'll go ahead and close our working tree diff. I'll switch back to Explorer view so we see our files. And then over on our infrared app.c, there's our other file with our change. And then we'll go ahead and do Control Shift B. And then this time we're going to choose release in brackets and then flash USB with resources. So if you're in a dev build, you may want to do debug. If you're using a hardware debugger and are actually going to look at assertions. But otherwise, release is probably a better choice. So that's going to take a little while it rebuilds everything. And then once it's done, it's going to transfer all those files over onto your Flipper Zero and then kick off the firmware install. So the changes we've made to this firmware will make it so that you always need your infrared blaster to send infrared. It'll no longer use the built-in port, but you can always revert back to an official firmware later. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and click the OK button, and then we'll scroll up to the infrared option. You can see the 5 volts got automatically turned on and that light turned on. We'll choose TV and say OK. And you can see the infrared lights are blinking. This is on official firmware. Please like and subscribe. And if you have any questions, please post them on the Discord server. Thanks a lot.